I'm Naina. I teach English Language and Literature in Vidyaranya High School. I have this difficult task, you know, of teaching children who don't really appreciate the beauty of the language anymore, because they are only thinking of English as a means of communication. Very many of them are only compelled to do English because it's part of the syllabus, and because they've been told that they'll get very good jobs if they are able to speak in English. And so the entire beauty of the language is lost. It does not go down well with them. And there are children who are sitting in class looking at me and saying, why should I do this? I mean, what relevance does Shakespeare have to me? And especially when I do a comedy, say, of Shakespeare's, then it's much worse, because there is no, you know, there may not be an ethical dilemma to discuss. And so they feel it's very trivial. What am I doing? And so part of the difficulty that I face is in getting them to understand that literature is relevant to life. It's relevant, and the focus of my teaching is to get them to realize that. And so I keep trying things like whenever we read a text, I try my best to make it relevant to contemporary life, to society in general, whatever's happening in the world, politics, whatever. Like, for example, class 9 is doing the story The Bet by Anton Chekhov, where there is a big debate about life imprisonment and capital punishment. And we are a country that has a notorious reputation of 2 hangings in the last year. So when I talked about capital punishment, I found that the story went down very well by itself. You know, generally, I have some skeptics in class, but this one seemed to have gone down very well with all. And then so I sort of latched on to whatever they were thinking. And then I brought in some articles from the newspapers, especially The Hindu. I brought in some articles. I picked up an essay of George Orwell called The Hanging. And I read them to them, and then sort of tried to draw out from them what they think about capital punishment. So many of them just voice public opinion. They just say, you know, they're crying out for capital punishment, especially with the Delhi raid and all that. And they didn't stop to think why that might be a problem. But after we sat down and talked about it, then I think many realized that it's very harsh, and there has to be much deeper thought before you hand out a death sentence. So basically, this is what I do, you know, try and pick up something from literature and try to make it very relevant to whatever is happening